Scholastic Audio presents Trespassers by Breena Bard. Read by Cassandra Morris with Matt Braver, Maxwell Glick, Katie Coster, and Tara Sands. And additional voices by Dan Bittner, Orla Cassidy, Cynthia Farrell, and Mark Thompson. This is us on the drive up to my family's summer house at Sand Lake. The scene is pretty much the same as every summer. Tall pine trees and scrappy little birch trees lining the country road. Our minivan bouncing along with the canoe expertly strapped to the roof. Dad's driving, and Mom is sitting next to him with her coffee, while my brother and sister...
Snap!
...play an obnoxiously loud card game.
Snap!
That is Simon, my little brother. He's in the back seat with my older sister, Morgan. Me? I'm sitting in the way back seat, just trying to read my book in peace. My name's Gabby. Gabby Woods. We're the Woods family.
Snap!
The book I'm currently devouring is Murder on the Orient Express. It's a murder mystery by Agatha Christie, with murder right there in the title.
Snap! I win!
Oh. Dad, are we there yet?
Another half hour, Gabby.
That's my dad.
Play again?
That's Morgan, my older sister.
Nah, I'm over Snap. Hey, Gabby, wanna play cheat?
I'm reading.
You're always reading.
So? You can play with Morgan.
It's no fun with just two players.
Leave her alone, Simon. Let's just play war.
Oh man, war is so boring.
All right, one last stop before the lake. Everyone say hi to Paul.
Hi, Paul.
The Paul he's referring to is the mythical lumberjack, Paul Bunyan. There's a small supermarket named after him that we always stop at on our way up to the lake. They have a huge statue of Paul Bunyan outside, leaning on his giant axe. Paul must be 100 feet tall. His axe must be 50. Paul Bunyan's has all the usual supermarket supplies, but also all the good summertime stuff. Watermelon, sunglasses, the ingredients for s'mores. Everything you need for an awesome vacation.
Okay, everyone pick out a few things you'd like.
That's my mom. She kinda runs the show around here.
And let's pick out a few healthy foods too, okay?
Yeah, sugar poppers!
I'm gonna check out the magazines.
Me too. While Morgan picks up some magazines, I grab a book or two. Or three. The Maltese Falcon. And then there were none. The Westing Game. Oh, Murder on the Nile. Oh yeah, more Agatha Christie. More mystery.
Gabby, you can't possibly read all those in 1 week.
Yeah, I can.
Okay, I know technically you can, but maybe you should spend a little time just having fun.
Who says a stack of books isn't fun?
I know, yeah, I know that.
Who's Dad talking to?
Probably work.
This is terrible timing. You know we leave for vacation today. Look, Greg, I can't talk right now. I'll call you later.
What's up, Dad?
Hey, Gabby. Just getting our fishing licenses. Mom is expecting us to catch dinner tomorrow.
Yuck.
How about you pick out some night crawlers? Juicy ones.
Sure.
Is everything okay?
Yeah. I wish they'd give me a straight answer.
Hey, Dad, can we get some fireworks?
But we already have nature's fireworks. Fireflies, huh?
Ugh, please. Mom?
Oh, yes, we have to get fireworks. We always set some off here when we were kids.
Okay, but no unsupervised pyrotechnics. We'll light them off together.
Yes. Jeez, Gabby, more books.
So?
Did you even pick out any snacks?
I think it's great that Gabby loves to read. Besides, Simon, you grabbed enough snacks for the whole lake. Okay, kids, all of you get in front of Paul Bunyan for a picture.
My brother and sister and I line up in front of Paul Bunyan's feet for a picture. Like, literally, we are barely as tall as his boots.
Honey, you should get in there too. Your family started the tradition after all.
Why don't you all get into the photo? I think I know how to work one of those fancy phone cameras.
Sheriff Rivera!
All right. Everybody say cheese. I think that's a keeper. Thanks.
Golly, I can't believe how big you kids have grown.
Any news in town this summer?
It's been pretty quiet this summer. Like everyone, we've all been mostly transfixed by the big Lumens trial down in Chicago.
Yeah, we heard he got a lucky break.
He's got good lawyers, that's what. Won't find much of that drama up here.
Thank goodness. We're looking forward to a relaxing week. Here we are, home away from home.
Dad pulls the van up the gravel drive toward our place, nestled between trees and other lake homes. Sand Lake stretches out behind it, glistening in the late morning sun, just a few fluffy clouds dotting the sky. Everything is in its usual place, and this is it. It's time for some serious vacationing.
There's Gene! Look at him swing that axe!
Our neighbor, Gene Henderson, is outside his house, chopping firewood. His house is right next door to ours.
Now, remember, guys, it was only this past December that he lost Emmy. He's probably still grieving, and he might not be his usual jovial self.
Yeah, maybe give him a little space this week. Be friendly, but not obnoxious, okay?
Okay, of course.
Gene!
Well, hello there, neighbors.
Hey, Gene, we missed you.
I was starting to think I wouldn't get to see you folks at all this summer.
Oh, trust me, we would have loved to come up here earlier.
How about you, Gene? How are you holding up?
I'm not gonna lie. It's been real lonely here without Emmy. But boy, am I glad to see you folks next door again.
You don't need your space?
Simon!
My space? Goodness, no. I've had enough space all winter and spring. What I need is some quality time with the Woods family.
Hey, I thought the Jacobsons were selling their place.
Dad points to a house a little further down the lake.
They did. Those are the new neighbors, the Martins. A couple from Chicago and their two kids. They've been here a few weeks now. I haven't seen them on the lake much, but I stopped by and said hello.
We'll have to go introduce ourselves.
While we bring the groceries into our house, I eye the new neighbor's cabin with suspicion, trying to imagine what the Martin kids are like. I'm not sure why, but I have a feeling I don't want to find out. Actually, to be honest, our place is more of a cottage than a house. Smaller, cozier, comfy couches and chairs, stacks of board games, Monopoly, Trivial Pursuit, Clue. And out the window, I can spy with my little eye our Adirondack chairs, fire pit, and the best hammock on the entire planet.
Just how we left it, huh, Gabby?
Plus a few spiders, yeah. Dibs on the top bunk.
Gabby, you're the only one who wants the top bunk.
After we unpack, Dad takes me and Simon out on the lake. Me and Dad in the canoe, Simon in a kayak, all of us in life jackets.
Ready to make some waves?
I'm gonna bring my book along.
I think we'll be too busy exploring for you to read much. If we're not back by dinner, send out a search party.
Mom and Morgan sit on the dock, waving as we paddle away.
And away we go.
I don't know if you've ever been out on a lake before, but there is so much to explore. My dad was right. Shh! Look! A mama duck and her baby ducks paddle by us, no more than 5 feet away. So cute.
Hey, look up there.
High above us is an eagle flying back to its nest, which is perched way up on top of a tree. Stop! Simon, stop!
What? You don't want a little lake water bath?
Look, Gabby, it's your favorite place on the lake.
We come around a bend, and there it is. Wow! A huge house up on a bluff overlooking the lake. We pass by it every summer, and it never fails to impress me. Part of what makes this house so amazing is that the entire wall facing the lake is made of glass. And there's something really mysterious about it. Have you ever seen anyone up there?
I haven't seen a soul for as long as we've been coming to the lake. It's probably worth a fortune.
Did anyone ever live there?
Oh, I'm sure at some point. You'll have to ask your mom about that. She would have been here about the time it was built. She was probably around your age, Gabby.
It's kind of creepy.
Yeah, I agree. Now, who's hungry?
Dinner at the lake usually involves corn on the cob, watermelon, and burgers on the grill. I set the picnic table on the deck while Simon gets a pitcher of ice water, and Morgan and Mom bring out the food. We're all so hungry.
So while you guys were out on the lake, Mom and I met the neighbors.
Oh, yeah?
Just the husband and wife. They stopped by to say hello. They were kind of weird. Oh, Morgan, I wouldn't say weird.
They were totally weird. The lady was overly friendly, like she was hiding something, and her husband wouldn't make eye contact at all.
They were a little unusual.
That's just a nice way to say weird.
Maybe they're criminals on the lam.
Hey, it's not crazy. John Dillinger, Al Capone, lots of criminals hide out in the North Woods.
Well, that's what we're doing here, isn't it?
Ha ha.
Did you meet the two kids?
No, we didn't see them. They're about your age, though. I'm sure you'll meet them.
That night, the moon is full and the lake is still. And we're inside, playing our classic cottage game.
Okay, fourth word.
Watch!
Time.
Time moving forward!
Future!
Oh!
Back to the future!
That's it!
Yeah!
The game of charades. Seriously, a classic.
That was too easy. Okay, come on, Gab. Book down. Let's show them how it's really done.
I put down my book, grab a piece of paper out of the bowl, unfold it, dial M for murder. Okay, this I can do. I make like I'm working an old-timey movie camera.
Okay, movie.
Holding up four fingers.
Four words. Hang on, I'll see who it is. Oh, hi there. Oh, I see. Well, sounds fun. Just a minute, I'll go get them. Gabby, Simon, it's the kids from next door. They came to see if you want to hang out.
We're playing a game.
We can finish when you get back.
But we don't even know them.
This is how you get to know them.
Yeah, who knows? They could be your new best buds.
Before you know it. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.